how to make a farmhouse style bed frame.
The most important part of this project is getting good lumber that has no bows and crowns or curves or anything like that. Especially if you're getting it from Menards, you're definitely going to check that good amount. Sometimes I typically go through 100 boards when I can only want to find 10, so definitely do your fair share of checking on that. So first, I'm going to cut these 1x6s down to 30 inches and 15 inches. Then you're just going to want to start stacking these puppies up. Pretty much just rack them up, just get 14 of each thing. Sometimes I sort them, sometimes you don't have to.
Alright, so the next step after cutting all your 1x6s is you're going to go and line them all up. You're going to take a tape measure from one side to the other, and you're going to measure out. And then that's the measurement that you're going to cut your 1x4s at, that you'll nail on, as you'll see. And then it'll be the backdrop of your headboard and footboard.
This next part, you're going to want to wood glue, so you're going to want to have a steady hand. You're definitely going to want to be good at math for this part. If you're not, good luck. You're going to want to go about 1/16th off the end, and then you're going to want to bring it out 30 inches. And you're going to want to bring that wood glue all the way down the 1x4. And then you're just gonna want to go down, putting two nails on each side and nailing it all the way down.
Some things in life are meant to fly, and others they were born to run. You can't tie down up and leave it like the changing of the seasons.
All right, so here is the backdrop of the headboard, and now you will do the same exact thing for the footboard. For the 15 inch 1x6s, and we're just gonna skip this step and go straight into the 4x4 side posts. All right, so now we're gonna cut the 4x4 and the 2x2s, and we're gonna attach them together, and then make the feet for the headboard and footboard.
After you cut the 4x4, you're going to want to pick the best side, because you obviously don't want that ugly side looking straight up. So you're going to want to pick the one with the nice knots, then you're going to want to drill some pilot holes. So when you go to drill in the screws from the 2x2 into the 4x4, it'll go in nicely and you don't have any wood splits.
Alright, so for this next step, you're going to attach the posts to the backdrop. And then you're going to put some wood glue, put two screws, one at the top and one at the bottom.
Like a runaway southbound train, like an Arizona desert rain, like lightning in the sky, like fireworks in July, like a left field home run ball.
Alright, so here they are standing together. We got the footboard and the headboard. The next process is going to be putting 2x4s on them. So we're going to put a 2x4 up here and a 2x4 on here. And then we're gonna finish it with the 2x6 on top of that.
Here you're gonna be adding some wood glue on top of the backdrop in the side post just to tie the 2x4s together.
Like a whiskey shot at last call, it's like she was made for moving on. That girl is going, going on.
Here you're going to be cutting the 2x6s 2 inches longer than you had cut the 2x4s, just to have that 1 inch overhang on each side. Then you're just going to mark it out on the bottom, so then when you go to drill it in, it's easier to see.
Can't hold on to letting go, change the way the river flows, loving hers like roping in.
Alright, for this next part, we're going to be putting 1x4s on the sides just to eliminate any gaps. I already cut my 1x4s, but when you cut them, you're going to want to make sure that they are exact the same length as the gap. And then after that, we're going to be putting some wood filler in the holes from the screws that we had to drill the 2x6s into the 2x4s. Alright, so when you already have them cut, you're going to put wood glue on the back side of them, and you're gonna line it up and put it right in there, and then you're gonna go on the back side and you're gonna go and you're gonna nail it in. And just like that, I have this one nailed in. Now I'm gonna go and do the rest, just the same way as you did the first one. All right, so now that you have all the wood filler dried, you're gonna come and take 80 grit sandpaper and you're gonna smooth everything down, touch up any rough edges and things like that. So you can come and take the 320 grit sandpaper to it. So during the staining stage, it's nice and smooth and no rough edges. Like a runaway southbound train, like an Arizona desert rain, like a lightning in the sky, like fireworks in July. All right, so for this next part, we're gonna be putting the braces that the 2x10 side rails will go on. So what I typically do is for this height of legs, I bring it up about 8 inches off the bottom, and you'll just do like you see here, and then you'll do that for every single. You'll do that on the back side of the footboard, and then you'll do that on the front side of the headboard. All right, so now I'm gonna be cutting this 2x10 down to 80 inches because that is the size of the king size bed frame, and you're gonna be cutting two of these down for one for each side. And then after that, we're gonna be sanding it and then moving on to the staining process. Like a left field home run ball, like a whiskey shot and last call, it's like she was made for moving on. That girl is going, going, gone. She ain't got one day to stick around. All right, so now for the final step, we're gonna be staining this. This is a personal preference. You can stain it or not, whatever you decide. All my customers prefer it to be stained, so I'm gonna stain it. And before staining, just make sure you wipe it down with a microfiber cloth if you do. And let's get into it. No sense in trying to slow her down. Like a runaway southbound train, like an Arizona desert rain, like a lightning in the sky, like fireworks in July. All right, and here's the finished bed frame. Everything's stained, clear-coated. To finish it off, you can choose to put 2x4s across if you'd like to put the mattress on top of that. That's typically what people tend to do with these. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. This was how to build a farmhouse-style bed frame. Like a left field home run ball, like a whiskey shot.